So once you've downloaded your DNA, you can also upload that to other sites to try out some of their tools and also use the tools that maybe the company you tested with doesn't have. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. A couple of weeks ago, I showed you how you can download your raw DNA file from all the different testing companies. And today, I'm going to show you how you can upload that data to some other websites. Now, the first thing to remember is not every company allows uploads from other sites. For instance, Ancestry and 23andMe don't allow you to transfer other companies' information to them. However, MyHeritage, FamilyTreeDNA, and JedMatch, which we'll go over, all allow you to transfer information from any of the companies into their website. So let's begin with MyHeritage. Now in MyHeritage, if we go up from the main menu to DNA, you can see that there is an option to upload DNA data. When we click on that, we go to this screen. And it gives us this option to upload. So we're going to click on start. Now it's important here that you recognize whether you're uploading your own DNA or if you're uploading somebody else's and that you have permission to upload somebody else's. You don't want to be putting somebody else's DNA information on a website that they haven't consented to. In this case, I'm going to upload my information. Now they have their service terms and also the DNA informed consent agreement. Make sure you read those before you check off these boxes. Now, once you click on upload, it's going to ask you where that DNA file is, and then you're going to be able to upload it. After you selected the file, you're going to have this screen coming up, and then once it's been filed, it tells you that it's done, and it gives you a number of what that file is. So let me show you where that is. When you go to DNA, back in the homepage, and you go down to manage your DNA kits, that's going to pull up this. And you can see here that this was uploaded on June 30th of 2018. And it's going to have some processing that it needs to do for the next little while. But in a couple of days, you'll be able to access all of the tools using that DNA kit. And uploading is that simple. MyHeritage allows you to manage multiple kits. And so one of the things that I have is I actually have all of my kits from other companies on MyHeritage. So the next one is GedMatch. Now in GedMatch, we can also upload data from multiple different companies. It's free to have an account at GedMatch, so if you haven't signed up, make sure you sign up for an account. Now GedMatch has their announcements on the opening page, and if you just scroll down, there will be a file upload section. And what we want is we want the generic upload fast. When we click on that, we come over here. Now they have detailed instructions about how to upload information from each of the different genealogy websites. You're going to put the name of the donor. And then if you want to put an alias, and this is so when other people see this DNA data, it's not going to have the name of the donor, but it can have some alias. So in this case, I can just put AL. You tell whether it's male or female. And then if you know the haplogroups, you can put those haplogroups in, but you don't need to. Now the next question is whether or not this sample is from you or whether you are authorized to upload this sample. So for instance, if you're managing kits for somebody else, then you should have gotten their consent to upload to GedMatch. If it's for yourself, then you can also answer yes. Next, it's going to ask you whose DNA this is and how you have that authorization. In this case, this is my DNA, so I'm going to click on your DNA. Now we have to go and select the file. So when we click on the browse button, it's going to open up a window so that we can select the file from our computer. And once that has been selected, then we can upload. Now, as you can see here, this next screen, it's going through each one of your chromosomes and looking at the information, reading that off. It's identifying all the information in that file, and sometimes it takes a minute or so. And then once it's done, you just want to leave that page open until it's done. It will tell you, hey, you have this assigned kit number. And you can write that number down, but I'll also show you here where you're going to be able to see that. But the other thing is that it has done its initial processing, but it hasn't completed all the processing to be able to use all the different tools. So it's going to take a couple of days to do all that processing to be able to use those tools. So coming back to the homepage, let me show you where you can actually find that kit number and be able to use things. If you scroll down, you can see that under your DNA resources, it's going to have your kit number right there. And then the tools that you can use are right over here. And again, with GedMatch, you can upload as many kits as you want to manage. Make sure though that you have permission from those people in order to upload them. Now, MyHeritage and GedMatch are free to upload your kits and to be able to use their tools. AncestryDNA also has an option of uploading a kit, although it is limited as far as the amount of tools and matches that you can see from that. I'll just quickly show you where you can go. On the homepage of AncestryDNA, if you go over to DNA tests, there is a link called autosomal transfer. You click on the autosomal transfer and then you're going to put in your information, join, and it's going to give you the option now to upload one of those kits. But in order to access their full suite of tools, it is a $19 or $29 transfer fee. So if you don't want to have to pay money, then AncestryDNA is not where you're going to want to transfer. Make sure you can transfer over to MyHeritage and try out their tools, or to GedMatch and use those tools there. And if you have any questions about uploading your DNA and where you can use that, put it in the comments below and I'll try to answer it for you. Don't forget to subscribe so that you won't miss another episode of Family History Fanatics.